A little bit of surprise there, but then catching up with him just minutes later after it all started to sink in, he was extremely confident and told our reporter, I'm not surprised one bit. Right. I told you all along that I didn't kill my
wife. Another man who might not be very surprised is his defense attorney, David Serna. And Regina Reese just talked with him. She joins us again live from the courthouse. Regina?
Well, David Serna says he's not surprised at all. He says there was no case in the first place. Now, we did ask him if he thought that putting Levi Chavez on the stand made the difference. He said no. Basically, he said he doesn't think that the defense had any bad days of testimony and had a solid case. Listen into what he had to say.
Reality, which is that there never was a case against Levi Chavez. This was a made-up pile of lies from the beginning, and it took the jury approximately 10 hours to find that out.
Now, we did talk to Serna. We asked him if Levi Chavez plans to become a police officer again. He says he has no plans for that in the future.
And you know, Regina, before, after we showed the video when you were talking to Levi Chavez, we were saying how we could observe, you know, from our vantage point here in the studio, but it seemed like he was extremely confident, wouldn't make eye contact with any of the media. Was that the sense you were getting?
That was absolutely the sense I was getting. I mean, I could barely keep up with him. He just wanted to go straight to his car and get out of here and put this whole case behind him, Doug and Shelley.
And Regina, David Serna said it was a pack of lies. Is he calling the prosecution liars, the mistresses who were on the stand liars? Did he kind of talk about who he's referring to as the liars in this case?
Well, he actually mentioned the Valencia County Sheriff's Department. He's really putting a lot on that initial investigation as far as where all of the lies came from and where the root of those lies were. And he's pretty convinced that, like he said, it was just a whole pack of lies.
As you saw Levi walking out, who else was who was he surrounded by? Did you see anyone from Tara's side?
Actually, Tara's family came out before. A lot of the family members came out before Doug and Shelley. He came out, and he was actually mostly surrounded by the media. The media kind of got around him, and he was just trying to make his way to his vehicle. So he wasn't really surrounded by anybody. The family came out beforehand.
It's kind of surprising in a highly contentious trial like this that maybe somebody from the prosecution side or Tara's family side would have been like waiting to confront Levi, because again, the animosity was talked about a lot, you know, both in the paper here on Action 7 News. The judge addressed it earlier as well. So it's kind of surprising that somebody didn't wait there and confront Levi.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, you could feel that animosity coming from Levi Chavez as he walked out of the courtroom. He was just very upset. But Tara Chavez's family, they came out and their heads were down and they seemed more solemn than anything. It didn't seem like they wanted to be confrontational tonight.
What's the sense of what's going on around you? It looks like it's pretty quiet, nothing much happening, but we can almost hear surrounding you that there's a little bit of a crowd. Are there still people mulling around the courthouse there?
Well, basically, the jurors just came out maybe about 10 minutes ago, so they have been making their way to their vehicles. A lot of media is still here, but as far as family, prosecutors, the defense, everybody's kind of cleared out of here.
All right, Regina, appreciate that live report. Of course, we'll be checking back in with you again later on as well.